so that you know the timeline, we're looking at about 1000 BC, and it is the time of the end of the judges, and it's the time right before the prophets. And so she's sitting, or this book is given to us right there at that time period where we're going to see that it wasn't a good time for the nation of Israel. And it's exactly like our culture today. And so it's neat because we can relate on a lot of those levels. Let's begin to look at it, and then I'll just break down stuff as I think about it. But verse 1 says, "Now it came to pass in the days when the judges ruled that there was a famine in the land. And a certain man of Bethlehem, Judah, went to dwell in the country of Moab, he and his wife and his two sons." So it came to pass. It's individuals that are Jew, governed by God, appraised to God is what Jew means, are supposed to look to God. They're supposed to trust in God. And so very much like us as believers, we are Christians, Christ-like. And the identifying mark of a Christian is, if anyone would come after me, Jesus said, you must first deny yourself, take up your cross, and follow me. And so that should be the identifying mark of us as Christians. Not that we come to church, not that we read the Bible, not that we pray, not that any of that. All of that stuff is good. There's nothing wrong with any of that. But as a Christian, to be Christ-like, we are to walk in obedience to what God is calling us to. We are to participate with Him and cooperate with Him as He is growing us up. To do anything less is to not be a Christian, is to give God the Heisman, to say no to God, to give God high-handed sin, and to say, God, I want to do my own thing. Then you're your own God, right? To do my own thing means that I call the shots. I run my life. I make the rules, and I'm going to dictate what I'm going to do. That's not a Christian. So we're not Christian in name. Yeah.